Good day, students. In this video, I am going to explain to you the concept of free surface area. The free surface of any liquid in any tank can only occur when the tank is not 100% full or it is not 100% empty. The free surface effect is affecting the stability of the ship, and this is what I will be discussing in this video. When the tank is not 100% full, it has a sloshing effect also, and that causes damage to the structure of the ship, but that is under ship construction. So in this video, we are going to study free surface effect and how it affects the stability of the ship. I imagine this is your ship cross-section view and you have a tank. In this case, I'm showing you a double bottom tank.
Sorry.
And it can be any tank. It can be a topside tank, deep tank, any tank. But here I'm just taking an example of a double bottom tank. This tank is 100% full. Likewise, on the figure on the right, you have a double bottom tank which is 100% empty. Now the liquid in that tank can be anything. It can be ballast, it can be fresh water, fuel oil, diesel oil, lube oil, anything. So here we have the keel. This is the center of gravity of the liquid in the tank. This is the center of buoyancy of the ship. This is the center of gravity of the ship. And this is the metacenter of the ship when she is in an upright condition. Likewise, the same structure applies here, except that there is no center of gravity of the liquid in the tank because there is no liquid in the tank. WL is your water line at which the ship is floating. Now consider those same figures that we saw in the earlier slide, and the ship is now healed. Since this tank was 100% full, the liquid in the tank has no place to move. It stays exactly as where it is and is considered to be solid. Therefore, the center of gravity of this liquid in the tank does not move down to the low side. Likewise, because there is no movement of any weight, the center of gravity of the ship also does not move. It stays stationary on the center line. What moves is the center of buoyancy, because underwater volume of the ship has changed, and therefore the center of buoyancy moves down to the low side and takes up a position at V1. This capital VV1 is parallel to small VV1. Small V here is the centroid of the immersed wedge, and small V1 here is the centroid of the submerged wedge. What acts vertically up through the new center of buoyancy is the force of buoyancy, which is equal to the displacement of the ship. And where this cuts the center line is the metacenter of the ship, denoted by the letter M. Same explanation holds good for this figure on the right hand side with no water in the tank, with no liquid in the tank. Now the moment of static stability, as we have studied in the earlier chapter, is found by the formula displacement into Gz. Gz here is the righting arm, also called the righting lever. And displacement into Gz is the righting moment. This tends to bring the ship back to its upright condition. And since this angle is theta and sine theta is equal to opposite upon hypotenuse, that is Gz upon Gm, so we substitute that in this formula and we get W into Gz is equal to finally W into Gm times sin theta. Now consider these tanks not to be 100% full or 100% empty. They are anywhere between 1% to 99% full. So the liquid in the tank is free to move down to the low side when the ship is listed. What happens? Let us study in the next slide. So here we have your tank. the same time, which is not 100% full, nor is it 100% empty. The K is the keel of the ship, small g is the center of gravity of the liquid in the tank, capital B is the center of buoyancy of the ship, capital G is the center of gravity of the ship, and capital M is the data center of the ship. Now this ship has a list. The liquid in the slack tank will move to the low side. So let us see what happens in the next slide. The ship has taken a list. The original water line was WL, which was parallel to the keel. The new water line is W1L1. And the liquid, which was evenly distributed on port and starboard side in the earlier slides, has now moved down to the low side. The center of gravity of the liquid, which was located at point G, is now located at point G1, which is the centroid of this triangular shape that is formed due to the shift of the liquid in the tank. This surface of the liquid in the tank is always parallel to the new water line at which the ship is floating. As we have seen before, small b is the centroid of the immersed wedge and small b1 is the centroid of the submerged wedge. The center of buoyancy of the ship will move parallel to the line joining small b b1 and it will settle down somewhere at this location of b1. The new center of buoyancy is now located at capital b1. And capital B, B1 is parallel to small b, B1. The center of gravity was located here initially when the ship was upright, even though she had a slack tank. Now, this center of gravity has moved parallel to small g, G1 and it has settled at capital G1, that is this point over here. So, the displacement of the ship, which was initially acting vertically down from the initial center of gravity when the ship was upright, is now acting vertically down through the new center of gravity position, that is at G1. The force of buoyancy is acting vertically up through the new center of buoyancy, capital B1, and it meets the center line at the point meta center, at a point called the meta center denoted by the letter M. The initial righting lever was GZ. If this had been full, if the tank had been full and the ship had healed, the righting lever would have been GZ. But since the tank was slack and she is now listed, the center of gravity has moved from capital G to capital G1, thereby reducing the righting lever from GZ to G1Z1. So the first effect that we see of having a slack tank is that the righting lever, or the righting arm, whatever you want to call it, gets reduced from GZ to G1Z1. Now GZ is perpendicular to the force of buoyancy acting vertically up. Likewise, G1Z1 is also perpendicular to the force of buoyancy acting vertically up from the new center of buoyancy. As I just mentioned, that the displacement of the ship is now acting vertically down through the new center of gravity at G1. Now you extend that backwards. You extend the displacement of the ship backwards till it cuts the center line. Where it cuts the center line is your virtual location of the center of gravity denoted by GB. Another way to look at it is you have this new GZ, which is much less than the initial GZ. You draw this parallel upwards till it meets the initial center line at G and of course it will meet the force of buoyancy at ZB and this initial center, the initial center line will be cut off at GB. That is your virtual center of gravity. This is angle theta, your angle theta, and sine theta is equal to GZ upon GM. So as you see over here, the initial GM when she was applied, or if this tank was 100% full or empty, would have been from GM. But because the tank was slack, the center of gravity moved from capital G to capital G1. And as you extended this backwards to cut the center line at the virtual center of gravity, the metacentric height GM reduced from GM to GBM. So this is the second effect of having a slack tank on the stability of a ship. The metacentric height reduces from GM to GBM, and the distance between G and GB is called your free surface correction, and this correction is always negative. So the effect of a slack tank on a ship's stability are twofold. One, it reduces your righting arm on the righting lever, thereby reducing your righting moment, and it also reduces the stability of the ship. Your initial GM now stands reduced to GBM. And this is the effect of just one tank. If there were multiple tanks that were slack on board, your GB would not be there, it would be still further out. And it would also be possible that it would be in line with the metacenter, that might be neutral equilibrium. It could also be possible that your GB could be above the metacenter, giving you unstable equilibrium, which is very, very dangerous. So it is always preferable to keep a check, a constant check on the tank condition. Do not have slack tanks on board. Either have them 100% full or 100% empty. Now we come to the next slide. How do you calculate this free surface correction GGB? This is calculated by this formula. I into RDI divided by V into RDO. Now this I is the moment of inertia. It's also called the second moment of area. It's also called the second moment of area. And this RDI is the relative density of the liquid within the tank. This I is the second moment of inertia of the slack tank. There will be many tanks slack on board the ship, so you have to find the moment of inertia of each and every slack tank on board. And multiply that with the relative density of the liquid in the tank. Now that liquid in the tank could be ballast, fresh water, lube oil, diesel oil, or heavy fuel. This is divided by V, which is the volume, and also divided by RDO. So in effect, the denominator is V into RDO. Now this V is actually the underwater volume of the ship. And underwater volume of the ship, and multiplied by RDO, the O stands for the relative density of the liquid in which the ship is floating. That is, it could be seawater, smog water, fresh water, and therefore we have this underwater volume of the ship multiplied by the relative density of the liquid in which the ship is floating, thereby giving you the denominator equal to the displacement of the ship. Now, since we are calculating this in the transverse direction, this second moment of area of the slack tank takes into effect L and B of the tanks. And the small L is the length of the slack tank, and small B is the breadth of the small tank, of the slack tank. So since it is in the transverse direction, the breadth is cubed. Therefore, the moment of inertia of this rectangle is equal to L into V cubed divided by 12. The moment of inertia of the slack tank in the transverse direction is L into V cubed divided by 12. The moment of inertia in the longitudinal direction would be L cubed into V divided by 12. But we are not going to consider that, we are just going to consider to be in the transverse direction. Hence, the breadth is cubed. And this plays a very significant role. The bigger the breadth, higher is the moment of inertia and greater is your free surface correction, thereby the effect on stability is much more by reducing the GM of the ship by a large quantity. So we will study about that a bit later. Hence we see over here, the free surface correction is therefore given by I into moment of inertia into relative density of the liquid in the tank divided by displacement. And moment of inertia is L into V cube as we saw over here divided by 12 multiplied by relative density of the liquid in the tank and divided by the displacement. The unit of free surface correction, as you have seen over here, is finally working down to meters. Now this week, what we saw was considering just one tank. If there are many such tanks which were slack, then you have to add up sum of all the free surface moments of all the slack tanks and divided by the displacement of the ship will give you the final free surface correction which has to be applied in the negative to the GM of the ship. So, that's it everyone. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up, share as well as please subscribe.